Greetings to you all. I've been passionate about sound for decades. I had an audio system in my room for as long as I can remember. I have also been working in the events industry since 2003. So I always try to look for inspiration from both consumer audio and professional products. French professional audio equipment manufacturer L-Acoustics is following a similar philosophy. They are known worldwide for their professional products, but not a lot of people know that they also have product lines aimed for the residential market. That's why I visited their showroom in North London and can't wait to share what I have experienced there. Just before I start, I'd like to encourage you to subscribe to Bortech channel. It is very important as your subscriptions are helping me to open doors to exciting places like this showroom. If you would like to support Bortech channel financially, you can use the Super Thanks feature here on YouTube or consider becoming a patron on Patreon. You will find all the useful links in the description down below. One more thing. Watch this video till the very end and you will get a chance to win a L-Acoustics goodie bag. Business Development Director Nick kindly agreed to tell us more about the L-Acoustics showroom.
So we're here today in the L-Acoustics showroom in Highgate, North London. L-Acoustics was founded in 1984 by Dr. Christian L, and he was one of the founders and pioneers of using line source array technology in live events. L-Acoustics has become one of the world leaders in live events for concerts, festivals, touring, and also now becoming a leader in the install section as well. And we've diversified over the last few years and are also now putting our loudspeaker products and amplified controllers into residential projects.
I have asked Nick to tell more about their top-of-the-range configuration.
With this room, we designed it first and foremost for the playback of Elisa. And we wanted to create what we call a hyperreal level of immersion, so it feels more realistic than actually if you were, you know, in the studio with the band. Now, the idea of this is, because of our background in science and engineering, is that all of the speakers are laid out, so when you are stood or sat in the optimum listening position, each of the frontal speakers is at a 15 degree angle to your ears, and the rear speakers are at a 30 degree angle to your ears. And that's the resolution which the human ears stop detecting sound coming from a source and can just hear sound coming from space. It's a really, really incredible way to be able to just have sound fill the space and not hear at all where it is. So that's why we have as many speakers as we have.
Most of you are probably familiar with speaker configurations such as 5.1, 7.1 or 7.1.4. The number of speakers in this showroom is closer to what a very advanced public cinema would have.
Within this space, as I said, it is 18.1.12, and we actually use the orientation of the room in a slightly different way, where our frontal stage is very, very wide. So we have our center channel, and then we have channels either side of that. We have three channels either side of our center channel, then plus we have surrounds all the way through to the rears. The space can be very flexible for lots of different audio formats because we have so many speakers, they can be used in any orientation or format you need.
So many speakers are capable of moving a lot of air and creating a lot of reflections within the room. That's why the space has to be acoustically treated.
So what we did is we built kind of a room within a room. So we have stretch fabric walls, we have a stretch fabric ceiling. And behind those walls and ceilings, we have lots of different levels of acoustic treatment, whether that be for bass traps, absorption, diffusion, and the ability to really make it a dry room so that it, you know, the sound system can be as good as it can be. However, it's also, you know, quite normal. So we wanted to show kind of really a happy medium between what could be real life and what is optimal.
Great. I believe that it is time to talk about the L-Acoustic speakers themselves.
So the room features 18 Syva enclosures. Syva is made up of 6 5-inch drivers within here for the mid-range frequencies. And then we also have 3 compression drivers here in what we call a waveform guide. So this is our DOSC waveform guide. It uses L fins. This is a patented technology. You'll see this in our bigger line array products that you'll see at concerts and festivals. And the idea of the Syva product is we wanted to take that L-Acoustics sonic signature, but make it into a form factor which was far more discreet.
All right, let's check the specs of the speaker. Syva is a two-way speaker with frequency response range from 87 to 20,000 Hz. Sound pressure level can reach a crazy 137 decibel. Its impedance is 8 ohms, they weigh 21 kilograms and require about 1000 watts of amplification. Another interesting parameter is the coverage angles. Vertical one is about 26 degrees and the horizontal one is a stunning 140 degrees.
With these speakers, they are all flat to the wall, they're not towed in any way. The whole idea of the waveform guide here is that we can control the directivity incredibly precisely of the high frequencies, and it's the high frequencies really that you need to control within a space. Here it stops here, and because it's curved into this J formation, it means that we get great dispersion coming down over the, you know, audience coverage area, but it also means it can be very wide as well, so the dispersion comes out and it gives true coverage across the space that it's being used in.
As Syva's lower limit is 87 Hz, they require their companion speaker to cover the lower frequencies.
The first box you would pair it with is called a Syva Low, which is two 12-inch drivers.
With these additional speakers, the system is able to reproduce frequencies as low as 40 Hz. Syva Low maximum SPL is also 137 decibel. Their nominal impedance is 4 ohms. Each speaker weighs 29 kilograms and they are IP55 rated. If you are not impressed yet, let's hear what Nick has to tell us about the subwoofers.
So within the front wall here, we have a mixture of Syva Low and Syva Sub. The reason for that is there are 7 Syva at the front here and beneath each Syva is a Syva Low. And then the Syva Subs are for the LFE channels. They're getting the dedicated LFE channel to them, the Syva Subs. In between each Syva Low is a Syva Sub, so it's a total of 7 Syva Low and 6 Syva Sub at the front.
Each Syva Sub has a single 12-inch driver in it. It can reproduce frequencies as low as 27 Hz. Its maximum sound pressure level is 128 decibel. Nominal impedance is 8 ohms and it weighs 27 kilograms. They are not the only subwoofers they have in this showroom.
Then at the back of the room, we have something slightly different. So at the back of the room, we have 6 Syva Subs, and these are actually in reverse polarity. And the idea of that is so that we are cancelling out the bass, so that obviously when the bass comes out of the room, there's a lot of energy. We have a lot of drivers here pushing a lot of air, and obviously there will be a lot of buildup at the back of the room. So with technology that we have the ability to be able to cancel some of that out to make sure it's a nice, even, smooth response completely throughout the room.
Just in case you've been counting individual speakers, you probably counted 43 of them so far. We are not going to stop here, as there are more.
Yeah, so within the system, we have 12 5XT loudspeaker enclosures from L-Acoustics. They're there to provide that extra level of immersion. So obviously with immersive audio formats, you have the ability to have height channels so that it truly feels as if, you know, if you're watching or listening to a scene where there's rain or something like that, that it genuinely feels as if it is all around you.
5XTs are two-way passive coaxial speakers. Because of their coaxial nature, they produce a 110 degrees axisymmetric directivity pattern. Their frequency response range is from 95 to 20,000 Hz. Maximum SPL is 121 decibel, nominal impedance is 16 ohms, and they weigh only 3.5 kilograms.
We couldn't see these speakers because they're behind acoustically transparent fabric in the room next door, but this is essentially the 5XT. So this is the loudspeakers that we have 12 of in the room next door for the overhead height channels. This is it in its standard color finish, which is a dark gray brown. It has a speak on connector on the back of it. It can be mounted on a pole. There are also U-brackets for it as well, so it can be mounted from a ceiling or on a wall, which is how we have it ceiling mounted up there. And then, yes, 5-inch coaxial point source driver inside of this unit as well.
Such a large number of speakers requires a lot of amplifiers. They have 14 of them to power up the system in this showroom.
amplification in this room, we are using LA4X amplifier controllers. All of the L-Acoustics amplifiers are all kind of designed to work with our ecosystem, so they are full DSP amplifier controllers. Like all of our loudspeakers and enclosures as well, everything is made in Europe.
LA4X are 4-channel Class D amplifiers. Their output power is 1000 watts per channel. What is very important is that they can achieve 1000 watts at all 4 channels at the same time. And it doesn't matter if you are powering 4 or 8 ohm speakers, LA4X will still output 1000 watts per channel. A total harmonic distortion is 0.05%. It has a built-in DSP, and that's why it is called amplified controller. I will include a link to full specifications in the description down below.
This is three equipment racks here that we have that are running not only our showroom, but also the studio space that we're in now. We have 14 LA4X amplifiers running the immersive sound space that we have next door. Each one of those is obviously connected to Syva, Syva Low, and Syva Subs. We also have an Lisa processor at the top, so this is our own immersive audio processor.
Lisa processor is designed for a real-time spatial audio processing. It can process up to 96 objects simultaneously and render them to as many as 128 outputs. It can be used in a small installations like this, as well as the largest tours or shows. Again, I will include the link to full specs in the description of this video.
So the Lisa processor allows us to do some incredibly clever things with live feeds coming into the room. So quite often we will be doing playback events with artists, and what will happen is they will give us the raw stems to their tracks, and the Lisa processor actually allows us to, on the fly live, make that immersive and spatialized for within that room. Beneath that, we've got an Lisa player. This is a playback device. This allows us to take those files and then essentially save them as files to be able to play them back.
So this was a little tour of the L-Acoustics showroom in North London. This was, and I'm not exaggerating, the most impressive setup that I have ever heard. I would love to come back and spend a day listening to my favorite spatial audio albums there. Please let me know in the comments what you think about this 18.1.12 setup and if you would like to know more about L-Acoustics products. Just before I go, as I have promised, I will do a little giveaway. People at L-Acoustics were very kind and provided the goodie bag for my viewers. It includes pencil, pen, Sharpie, light, bottle opener, L-Acoustics USB, sticker pack, notebook, stick notes, leaflet, and the t-shirt. To enter the draw, you just need to like this video, subscribe to Bortek channel, and leave a comment, "I want L-Acoustics goodie bag," followed by the name of the country that you are from. I will wait until this video reaches 10,000 views and then announce the results. Good luck! So this is it for this video. As always, your likes and subscriptions are much appreciated. So stay tuned and I will see you soon. Goodbye.